stereotypical group the American dad who strives to prove that everyone is group. While opposed to us is right forward athlete, which comes from the Greek word athos. Athos is translated as legendary feet, so there you go. Martyrs of monastics in the Orthodox Church are also described as athletes. They are indeed legendary, and they propose an example for us to follow. The faith of the saints has been tested in many ways. The martyrs endured persecution and injustice, which manifests how much they love Christ. Take as an example the Apolipikio, for a woman martyr. O Lord Jesus, unto you your land you cry with a great voice. O my bride, who I love, I am seeking now, I contend with your baptism, am crucified and buried. I suffer for your sake, that I may reign with you. For your sake, I die, that I may live with you. Genuine love presupposes sacrifice, and their sacrifice is exemplary. Their martyrdom oftentimes caused physical pain and suffering. Did martyrs exhibit superhuman physical strength to sustain such tribulations? Could we even compare them to champions of athleticism who have trained diligently in order to emerge victorious in sports arenas? Physically, martyrs are no different than any of us. However, their strong faith and love for God empower them to become victims of the faith. I love to read their lives, which inspires us to emulate their example. We all ought to be martyrs. Even the word martyr is a Greek word, and by this time causes us to patriotically triumphant. The word is derived from Athenia, which is the witness of the faith, to bear testimonies to the teachings of Christ. A martyr is very much an athlete. An athlete needs a good coach. We need our spiritual fathers to listen to our confessions and to pray for us. An athlete needs to know the rules of this word. We read the Bible and the patristic wisdom to adhere by the precept of the faith. An athlete requires cheap training, hard work, good nutrients, and perseverance. We have prayer, fasting, the sacrament of salvation, and philanthropy. An athlete needs a team to coordinate with and to trust the fellow teammates in order to function as one organic union. We have the church, we have each other, to trust, to love, to pray together in sacramental union. We win together, and losing is not an option. Not one of us should be missing from the banquet of salvation, heaven. Martyrs are champions of the faith, victors in the arena of salvation. But martyrs are not just icons you see in the name and the story you read in the books. We can all be martyrs, witnesses of the good news. We will stand good news of salvation and the gospel of our Lord and Savior. And we will stand before governors and kings for my sake, to bear witness before them, and the gospel must be proclaimed to all nations. Mark chapter 13, verses 9 through 10. The Bible compels us to fight the good fight. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7. And to become champions of faith, and to emulate in Christ in becoming holy. Leviticus chapter 11, verse 44. And 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 16. An athlete of the faith never quits, but always struggles for perfection and victory. This requires sacrifices and hard work. But when we love the faith, we live the faith. And in following the examples of the athletes of Christianity, we ought to play hard in order to win the crown of redemption. Play hard, pray harder. Thank you.